All right, welcome back. In the previous series of videos, we have seen how to work with the UiPath Studio to automate a process using activities. So in this video, we will take it forward and we will see quite interesting topic like UiPath RE framework. So agenda of this video is what is a robotic enterprise framework? Why to use robotic enterprise framework, and also we will see architecture of this enterprise framework and also some of the benefits of enterprise framework. The first you will see like what is robotic enterprise framework. First of all, what is framework? Framework is something, a package built for developer to help building quick and efficient process or programming. So you have already seen like some of the framework in the .NET libraries like MVC framework is there, which provides certain kind of built-in package or template to start or develop the task. So in UiPath also provides a template that has well-written structure that is used for building a robust large-scale solution that works based on queue transaction. So robotic enterprise framework is a template provided by the UiPath which help us to start the development without worrying about certain small but very important concepts like error handling or logging or case handling, etc. Okay. So why to use robotic enterprise framework? As I mentioned before, so this RE framework makes developers life much easier because it provides a template, built-in template, and user can start implementing actual process instead of worrying about killing other application opened or unnecessary applications opened or error handling or logging, etc. So it works as a template and provides all the basic details that you as a developer may need for any process automation. So if you see my previous videos, we have developed a process to automate the website like employee generation ID website or sales report generation website, etc. So in those process or project, so I have not followed any pattern. So as per the requirement, I designed my process like added activities and captured or spied out elements and accomplished my job. But in actually, there are something I missed out, like error handling or when there is no data for transaction, then what robot should do? Those things I didn't implemented in my previous application or process. Okay, so those are like, as I mentioned before, the small but very important concepts we need to take care about. Otherwise, robot will fail in some or other cases. So this RE framework provides all those basic kinds of information. Lets you read and store the config data. Yes, that is one of the important concept. So suppose if you are launching a website from UiPath Studio, you are required like the URL, or you are launching some sub websites from that website, then also you might require some URL, and also you might require some delay or waiting period to the website to be loaded before begin the process. So those kind of timeout delay or any URL, or if you need any global values that can be used throughout the process, that you can place it in your config data which is provided by the RE framework. Okay, So also it also does like open the required application, close all unnecessary applications, get the transaction and process it. And when required, it allows to retry the transaction. Suppose you can mention the retry count in such a cases, like suppose there is a error, system error or business error, business logic error occurs, then what it should do, where it should go. In those cases also, you don't need to worry. It has built-in workflow that will take care of it, and also logs the status of all processed, failed, successful transactions. So let us see like architecture of RE framework. So RE framework contains four main components. One is init state and transaction state, process transaction state, and end process state. Let's assume like our website, sales generation report website, we need to automate the website, and in that website it provides like input data as well. We need to download the Excel sheet from the same website, okay, and we have to extract the data from the input for downloaded Excel file, and we have to feed it to the fields of the same website. So there are certain activities we need to perform over here. The first thing is like the URL of a website, that we can store it in the config file as a key value pair, one thing. And second thing is like we need to launch the browser, that also we can perform that activity in the init state. After after launching the browser, we need to download the Excel from the same website, that also we can have it in the init state, because these are all activities needs to be done to perform the actual process, I mean feeding data, that is the actual process, okay. So that those things we can have it in the init state. And next comes to the transaction state. This works as like watchman or a gateway for the process. So what it does actually, it will take care of like whether the transaction data is there or not for the transaction. If there is data available, then what it should do, it will pass the data to the process state. The process state where we actually place our activities to perform, the feed the data onto our website and clicking on submit action. Those activities, we need to place it in the process transaction state. This will actually process the data. Suppose there is no data available in the transaction state, then what it should do? Suppose let's assume like there is only one row in the Excel file. So the first row, that there is a data available, then it pass the data to the process state that will perform the action, I mean feed or it will feed the data onto the our website fields, and it will click on submit action performed. Okay, so if there is no data, there is no second row in the Excel sheet, then what it does do, there is no data available for transaction, so it should end the process. So if there is no data, then it comes to end the process here. So that is where the transaction data state works, okay. And once all the transaction over covered, so it comes to the end process. Suppose if there any error occurs, that also like handled by the RE framework itself. Like when error handles at the process state, then it what should do, it will move on to the init state, and again it will perform the same read operation, and it will try to perform the actions as we mentioned. Okay, so these are the four components are there. In the coming videos we'll see the workflow components, like workflow, or if you consider like init state, what all components involved in init state. So all these things we'll go in depth in the further coming videos. So UiPath contains three data flows. One is sequence is for simpler linear data flow activity, and flowchart is bit complex, is for bit complex data flow, and it has like two dimension two-dimensional, and also it can be reusable in some other project as well. State machine, something quite different, which is depending on, or it is a event driven data flow or workflow. So though ORI framework contains all the three data flows, but the main structure of the program is built using the state machine because the event driven, as it provides more clean and functional data flow representation. We will look into the state machine and etc. in the coming series of videos. In this video, we'll see simply understand the ORI framework and how it works, etc. So as I mentioned before, init state, this is the initial state which is used to read and store the config data in the dictionary, close all the unnecessary applications and open the required one. So if you're familiar with .NET Core applications, in the .NET Core, when the application initializes, it will read the data from the app settings and it will holds in the container for the further programming or further use. In the similar way, when the process starts in the ORI framework, so it reads the data and store the config data as a dictionary key value page. Okay, so get transaction state, it is the data retrieval state which is used to get the transaction from a queue or table or a folder. It can be any data source. It will read the data and keep it for the transaction. Once the bot is successfully initialized, all the application it requires for the process. So when the bot initializes, successfully initialized, all the applications it requires for the process, it holds in it. Okay, hence it looks for any transaction items in the orchestrator queue to process. So it will hold all the data which is required to process the actual activity, like feeding data to the website or anything. And next is process transaction. The transactions or processes that are fetched from the previous state, that means get transaction state. And if there is no record to process, the robot automatically moves to the end process state. This automatically handled by the ORI framework. The last one is end transaction. This is the final state of ORI framework that ends the robot successfully and closes all the applications. After the bot has finished processing all the transaction items from the queue, it will log out of applications irrespective of it is failed or successful transaction. It will keep all the logs and everything. It will close the application once it reached the end transaction state. So what are the benefits of robotic enterprise framework? Why do we need this actually? So some of the concepts I already explained. The reusability. So the reusability in the sense like it works for any type of process or business. Like it can be implemented in small or big larger process as well. Scalability. Ability to retry a failed transaction multiple times and send exception notifications. So it has a built-in workflow to handle the transaction or retry operation. That retry count, we can specify it, how many times it should retry the operation, and it should notify to the admin or user. Effective logging provides an effective logging mechanism to monitor the process and error handling. Error screenshots. This is one of the best I found in the ORI framework to handle or to know where exactly the error occurred. ORI framework has the functionality to take a screenshot of the screen at the point where it gets failed. This is very helpful for developers to analyze and resolve the issues by using these screenshots. Exception handling makes exception handling piece of cake. It has functionality to take actions when the exceptions comes. Consistency. The variable assets and settings are consistent across the ORI framework that makes it easy to understand. This obviously, since this is a framework, it should have certain guidelines, and when we create a project, it will create certain ground level project setup. What all things are required, like config file, folder structure, everything will be created by default for the development. So like if you create a project using the MVC in Visual Studio, so what happens, it creates the basic folder structure, how it should be and where we need to start. Those, the basic ground level setup it provides for us, and which is consistent throughout the all projects. So these are about the robotic enterprise framework. Thank you for watching this video.